Felix Baumgartner, famous for his jump from a height of 39 kilometers, in free fall faster than the speed of sound. Now he sets himself the next big challenge, the 24 hours on the Nürburgring. It is the 42nd edition of this long distance classic, but for the Austrian it is not only a premiere, but the highlight of his ambitious project, from heaven to green hell. Participation in the 24-hour race on the legendary North Loop, the Green Hell, the most spectacular racetrack in the world. Everything I've heard about the 24 hours race is not only confirmed but exceeded. It's incredible here, the crowds, the fans, the people, so enthusiastic and motivated. Great weather, the best conditions. The car is very advanced. Thanks again to Pierre Kaffer. We're ready to go. The atmosphere before the start is electric. Even celebrities like TV star Thomas Gottschalk enjoy the incredible tension. For the newcomer in the cockpit, Felix Baumgartner, it's still the calm before the storm. I'm still relaxed. Since I'm not the first driver, my tension's not so high. I think Pierre is really motivated. You can see it in his eyes. But at 7, when I'm on standby and go to the car at 8, then I will look a bit different. Felix Baumgartner will line up with Pierre Kaffer, Marco Werner and Frank Bieler against about 30 competitors in the GT3 class. They can all get overall victory. And first, they chase the pole, a McLaren. 8 top brands are at the start, including BMW, Mercedes and Porsche. Audi sends a total of 8 Audi R8 LMS Ultras in the hunt twice around the clock. At 4 o'clock, the 165 cars take up the chase for 24 hours on the 25-kilometer-long North Loop. Kevin Estre in the orange McLaren gets off to the best start. Behind him ensues a hard battle for the places. Felix Baumgartner, who will only take over the Audi in 8th place as the 4th driver, is amazed by the hot pace of the Profi drivers at the start of the day. As in a sprint race, the contenders quickly try to gain places and overshoot the mark. Several accidents mean a premature end for many teams, and that in the first hour of racing. The leading McLaren does not escape without incident in the first lapping maneuver. It scrapes a BMW from a lower vehicle class, which promptly ends up in the crash barrier. Due to this, the Mercedes with the number 23 is robbed of a chance of overall victory. Due to the many yellow stages and the consequent loss of tire temperature, Marc Basseng loses his Phoenix Audi with the number 3. Thanks to the high safety standards, no drivers or marshals are injured in the accidents in the turbulent initial phase. In the 24-hour race, the drivers take more risks. They're more impetuous. Like in the first hour, cars got smashed up. It wasn't necessary. After almost 3 hours of racing and several changes of lead, the Phoenix Audi with the number 4 and Markus Winkelhock at the wheel takes the overall lead, closely followed by the Black Falcon Mercedes SLS with the number 14. At 2017, the 24-hour race has been underway already for over 4 hours. Felix Baumgartner's time has come. Now it's just a very slight tension, but not too bad. But when I put on the helmet, then I'm almost already in the car. Pierre did a good job, Marco Werner too. Frank Bieler is driving so constantly, you can set your watch by him. We're in 9th place. I hope not to lose too many places in my stint. A few for sure, because I can't match the pace or performance of the best, but I'll give it a go. Felix Baumgartner drives laps in about 9 minutes, very respectable for the rookie. The leading cars are about 30 seconds faster. Baumgartner takes no risks and hands over the car undamaged to teammate Pierre Kaffer. I got through the traffic fine, but it's very difficult. There's often 3 or 4 cars in front of you, slow cars, and all swerving in different directions. You've got to watch out not to get maneuvered into something. Very difficult. The low sun was very difficult. It blinds you so you can't see the turning points. Felix Baumgartner recovers from his first appearance and tries to sleep a couple of hours during the shortest night of the year on the North Loop. The overall lead remains the same during the night. The Phoenix Audi with the number 4 drives best through the darkness and retains the top spot. Next morning, shortly after sunrise, it's time for Felix Baumgartner's second deployment. But the preparation could have been better. I went to bed pretty early after my last stint. I got a short massage, but I didn't sleep really well. It's so noisy in the hotel room, all the cars going by. I know I can only sleep for 3 hours, but I can never sleep if I know I have to go back out soon. Then I sleep badly. Felix Baumgartner gets into the car at 6 a.m. for the second time during this 24-hour race. He is, with his team at the moment, eighth in the overall rankings, and increasingly gets to grips with the conditions in his second appearance. And for the first time, he breaks through the magical 9-minute barrier. He has clocked at 8 minutes, 59.7 seconds. His best lap time on the North Loop at the 24 hours so far. I feel good on almost every part of the track. Best is out there on the North Loop, better than the Grand Prix track, but I have no problems. But then problems occur at a routine pit stop in the morning. Unexpected problems. Problems with the vehicle. The collar of the drive shaft broke, and when the fat comes out, it gets hot and eventually it breaks. So it tears the basket, more or less. And you must do that if you see something. We see that with a wheel change. It gets checked. Then we change it straight away. It took 26 minutes, but we're still driving. That's the most important thing. The potential top 10 ranking is thus out of reach of Felix Baumgartner and his team. That means our safety margin for the top 10 is gone. In other words, we have to attack more. But what fascinates me is this choreography. You see 15 people at the same point and everyone knows exactly what to do. The high-pressure repair of the team of mechanics has paid dividends. The car sets off furiously to catch up in the closing stages of the race, from 12th place. Felix Baumgartner also intervenes in events again. He gets support in the pit from his parents, who cross their fingers for their son in his last appearance in the race. Thanks to a strong performance by Marco Werner, Frank Bieler, Pierre Kaffer, and newcomer Felix Baumgartner, the Team Audi race experience make it into the top 10 after all. The quartet are the second best Audi of the race as overall ninth. I think they're all more than happy. Ninth place, first 24 hours race with the dream team, now a well-deserved bottle of beer, as good as it gets in the first year. Yes, it's terrific for someone who had never done such a thing like this before. And to drive a vehicle here on the North Loop is a huge task. And to master it so quickly and to do that, I take my hat off. Few people could do this. Audi also wins the overall victory at the 2014 24 Hours with the R8 LMS Ultra from the Team Phoenix with a new distance record. But there's someone to watch out for in the future. We'll be back for sure. It seems that the green hell is Felix Baumgartner's new heaven.